So, whether developing project management skills provide you with the foundation of developing the other skills required to be effective leadership, communication, and strategic assessment. We don't learn these skills from the books, and many engineers will move through their entire career never learning them. So, to give you a deep insight of it, today we have Mr. Tarun Jain. Mr. Tarun Jain has experience of 25 years in project management and network infrastructure. He has also been designated as the vice president while working with Bank of America. Currently, he's managing infrastructure project for HCL in Europe and APAC region. We welcome you, sir. We also have Dr. Harish Mittal, principal, BMIET, Dr. Abhinav Juneja, associate director, BMIET, Dr. Rishal Jain, dean, academics, BMIET, and all our fellow professors and students. Over to you, Tarun sir.
Thank I believe you are able to see my screen.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Thanks, and good evening, everybody. I would like to first thank to BMIT management, Mr. Jain, Mr. Juneja, and Principal Sir for giving me the opportunity to speak on project management and interact with the with all of you. So, project management, we all basically number of times we speak about the project management, and whenever we're doing any project, so we always ask, do you know project management? But actually, what exactly is the project management? Why it is required? So there's a one good line I have seen, like from Henry Mintzberg, and he said, management is above all a practice where art, science, and craft meets. So this is above all the things that we have into the what in arts or science or craft and where it meets. So I'll first go into the agenda the today. So what we are covering, I'm covering on the definitions, what the why the project management is required, what does we mean by project, what are the critical success factors, project phases and the framework, very important risk management, project triangle, human resources, and what's next? And this is a question all of you would have in your mind. What is the next after engineering? So first I'm covering the meaning of the project management. What is project management? Project management is basically an application of knowledge, skills, tools, and techniques. This is combining, and then we are able to deliver one project. Where we have a team which carries the whatever the work that is required to deliver. We have a project manager for the same thing who schedules the thing, monitor the things, control. So these are the basically all the things that we have in a project management. Then why project management is an important ingredient for successful engineering career? Like I said, engineer can run a project. This is no doubt that we cannot run a project. We are not debating on that. But he won't be on a successful until unless there's an equally skilled project manager is working with him or he has good management skills with him. There is a one study which globally Harvard and the Gallup, they've done. So what they have seen, when we are investing $1 billion invested in any project, there is a loss of $122 million that got wasted because we have not have done good project management. And there's some scope creep, there is some overruns, some project timeliness. So basically the question that all of you would have, $122 million is a big money. Why this get lost? The reason is we have think about the something and we deliver something. So I will cover in my subsequent slides so then you will understand in a better way. This is a classic example. A customer asked that I need one trolley with the wheels and red in the color. So this is simple red robust with the wheels that his customer required. A mechanical engineer and architect basically was working on it. He understand that this is something like this. The picture is coming on your screen. So this is the four wheels and with the handles and with the mirror. So it looks like that way. Then architect defined and described it like this way. Then finally, manufacturer expected to do like this is what he is expected that this is what he is required to do. And then finally, they develop this. So you can see the difference what the customer expect and what we have delivered. The reason is that there is a no proper communication. There's a no scope definition was there. There's a no like sizing of requirement was there. That is the reason there's a big gap and we have lost a lot of money in efforts. We have lost a lot of time. We have lost of even the credibility issue because we have not able to deliver the what the customer asked for. Another example, I will share it with you guys. This is, let's say, the circle. The blue circle is something that the customer needs. And we have the specifications. So this is that we understood that this is the specification. Architect or a solution developer or like for the mechanical engineering side, electronic engineering side, he understands the specifications. And then this is what he has been realized, the red circle. And you see the our quality where the two circle intersects. And now the result in front of you that only the where the three circle intersect is the adequate quality. Otherwise, it's the unsatisfaction customer, the errors in the specifications, waste. So this is all together the wastage and that what we have captured in the previous slides. That's a $122 million will get waste against $1 billion investment. It's because of this, because we have not sized the things correctly. We have not sizing of the scope correctly. We have not understood the requirement. We have not understood correctly the specifications. So that is the result that we have it like this adequate quality that we are not able to deliver. So if we say what is project management about, project management is. Project management is not a rocket science. It's something is connecting the points from point A to point B. First, we design the things, then we develop, then we analyze, evaluate, and this comes to the project management. So what I believe is everybody, all engineers or everybody can be a good project manager if they have like they can analyze on these particular things. We will capture in our subsequent slide what are the prerequisites to be a good project manager or how we can manage the projects and all. Till the time, if anybody have any questions, so please feel free to ask.
So we'll continue with the questionnaire round in the end.
Okay, good. So next, what is project? I believe this is the question most of the people this thought that if they're doing some activities at a project, no. Project is a temporary endeavor undertaken to create a unique product. This is a definition from a project management book. We call it the PIM book. But if you see, if anything that we start having a definite start and end date is in a project. If let's say I have started a construction of building, I said this will start somewhere on the 1st of May and end by 31st of December. So this has a definite start and definite end date. Anything that has a definite start and end date is called a project. And it is performed by the people, by the limited, constrained by limited resources. We have a resources that is defined for us that you have to complete this project with this resources only. We have complete planning, execution, and everything in a place. So I will cover into the mice. Like this is into the aviation sector and somewhere into the like into the banking sector that we have the project manager plays a very important role. Example of the projects, what are the basically projects that we can say? Developing a new product or service, hosting any event, designing a new product or service, affecting change in a structure, staffing, or style of our organization, even changing the complete staffing in any engineering college or anything, basically. Transportation vehicle, the mechanical engineers, developing or acquiring new modified information system, constructing a building or faculty, running a campaign for political office. This is again a project. If any XYZ political party, they said, I have a campaign to run during the election period. This is a project because this has a start date and a end date and date. Implementing new business procedures and processes. So this is the basically what we have seen into the example of projects. Then what are the characteristics of a project? Like we said, the project has a definite start and end date, and the project duration is finite. This has 1 year, 2 years, or some 5 months, 6 months. This has a definite duration. Project basically is a kind of opportunity to develop something innovative or something unique that we deliver or we develop. So these are the characteristics that we have in a project. This is what I've captured, a sample of a project plan, and this plays a very important role. In fact, if we see in our daily lives also, if we are work as a student, we are doing a graduation or a post-graduation, engineering, medical, or anything, this plays a very important role. There are the columns, task name, there we capture all the tasks. What are the tasks that we have to complete that particular activity? So, and the second is a duration, how many days it will take. Then there's a start date, finish date, then it will come a responsibility. Those are the columns, it's not captured here, but this is a Microsoft project plan. It's a tool where you can plan your project, and you have you can basically track it on the basis of percentage of completion. Let's say you have a first activity on row number 4, that this is a 20% completed. Row number 5 is 10% completed. So you come to know at any given point, how much your project is completed and how much percentage is left, so that you are able to easily track it on this MPP project plan. And it creates a very good, you can see onto the right hand side, there's this horizontal bars. This depicts basically how is the network is connected. It is called a Gantt chart also. It's a very famous Gantt chart, and you can easily make it how it works. And other important thing in this project plans, you know that who's doing which activity. Completing a program, let's say this is some A person is doing. So I know I can track it, this particular activity is done by the A and he has not done. It has to be finished on the Tuesday, 6th of Jan or this date, but it's not completed. So I can easily and go and ask this person why this is not completed. So this is the role of the project manager, and this is how the project management works. This is not I'm a mechanical engineer, or I'm a computer, or I'm an electronics engineer. It will not work for me. It will work for everybody, even for the doctors, even for people working in the pharmaceutical, people working into the aviation industry. This is very critical. I mean, even the metro project, this is starting in May 2005 in India. And this project management plays a very important role in having all the milestones the dates that they have defined to meet up the dates. We will go into the further jargons of project management as well, like the milestones, like stakeholders, other things. So the next, what are the benefits? We have discussed during earlier previous slides, what's the project management, what are the projects. So what are the benefits? It gives you the improved and increased customer satisfaction, which we call as a customer delight as well. Customer got delighted if their product will be get delivered on time, within the budget, within the timelines, within the scope. So customer will be get delighted. And then there's a chances of they will deliver the next project as well to you. So this will improve growth and the development within your team as well. Opportunities to expand your services, increase risk assessment, quality, quantity. So these are all the benefits. I don't want to go into the each and all. This is a simple English. So going to the next one. These are some critical success factor, or we can say three pillars of any project management: scope, cost, and schedule. If you know what is the scope that of that particular project that I have to carry out, I know that these are the project boundaries and I have to complete within that boundaries that particular project. I know that this is the cost I have budgeted. I have budgeted somewhere the $1 million USD for this project. So I have to complete that within that $1 million. So, but before that cost, we have to budget that. We have to estimate like how that 1 million will arrive. Then the scheduling. Scheduling part is basically we are sequencing all activities. Like this activity complete in a 1 month, this activity will take somewhere around 2 months. So we will complete, do the analysis on the man hours or the man days. Like this is how that complete project will complete in that particular time period. And this overall triangle will give us quality, which we are delivering to the customer or which we are delivering to our own organization. Let's say I'm working for my the college. So I'm giving it to the, that particular college, that quality. So coming to the next one. What are the prerequisites of for project managers? Like you say, can be a good project manager. I'm an engineer. Can I be I'm a good project manager? Yes, you can be a good project manager. You have to have the good communication skills, planning skills. You should know about the financials. The good part is, good thing is you should know about the conflict management, negotiations, influencing skills, leadership, team building and motivation. These are the important ingredients that each and everybody should have if he is pursuing his career into the project management or even in the technical field if he is going. And if he has this skill, he will overshadow his peers. He will do an excel in his job. So this is a very critical and important. And in fact, in our daily life also, we see that this plays a very important role. This is the metrics that shows how the project management is. This complete matrix is the yeast of the whole project management. It is divided, if you see the vertically, we have the 10 rows. This 10 rows shows the 10 knowledge areas. And horizontally, if you see, this is the 5 processes, which is like any project is divided within this 5 processes. To start any project, we have to start from the initiation, then we do the planning, and after the planning, we have execution, then we have a monitoring and control, then we have a closure. So this is the 5 phases that we have. We divide the any project into this 5 phases. And if we go horizontally down, we have like the 10 knowledge areas, like integration management, scope, time, cost, quality, risk, communication, procurement, stakeholders. So we will go one by one in each knowledge area. Integration management. Here, if you see the first cell, which has the initiation as well as the integration management, is a develop project charter. To start any project, we develop a project charter. This project charter has the complete overview of scope, the overview of like budget, financials, who are my stakeholders, what are the risk areas. So this gives them a one sheet, a complete synopsis of how my project looks like and what will be like following the project. I can easily see like this project is a red, amber or green. So it's famously called RAG in a project management language, red, amber and green. And then second, if you see this integration planning, just below the planning and the row of the integration, develop project plan. What we have discussed in the previous slide, creating a project plan, divided into the five phases: initiation, planning, execution, monitoring, and a closure. So we, any project when we create, we divide this into the five phases. Initiation, we have the complete understanding, like what are the things that we have into the initiation phase. Then we plan it, we collect the requirement, define sequencing, estimate budget, plan quality. So those are the things that we come into the planning. Then we have an execution, we execute the things, where is implementation comes into the picture. It's the real work that we do into the execution. Then there's a monitor. Once product is completed, then we have to monitor the things. Everything is under control, or we are able to do the monitoring. And the finally, we have to take a sign off is closure. Because anything when we deliver, we have to take a sign off. Like this is completed as per the whatever you have asked for, we have deliver the same thing. Then the same way vertically, if I go down on second scope, scope is like we have the discussion collecting the requirement, and this again comes into the monitoring and control, where control the things. Then time, which plays a very important role in defining and sequencing the activity. Like we had the discussed 1 month, 20 man days, 10 man days. So that sequencing of activity, hours, and who, which resource will do what work, it will come in the time. Then we have a cost. We estimate that this project will have this much of man hours and this much of the efforts from resources perspective. Then we know that this much of the procurement that we will do. So that will come in the cost. Quality, like we have seen into the project management triangle, there's a cost, time, and scope, and the quality that we deliver. So this is we have to plan for quality as well. Resources, without resource, there's no project can be completed. You have to have the manpower. You have to have the adequate resources to work on any project. And for that, you have to develop a project team. Like I'm delivering our data center for one particular organization. So I have to have the Wintel engineer, I have to have the security engineer, I have to have somebody from the networking side, I have to have somebody from the Linux side, somebody from the Unix side. So this is how we develop the team, project team, who works in a tandem to deliver one particular project. Risk. We always take this name a risk, but sometimes we are not aware that what exactly is the risk. So, excuse me, can I take a water? Sorry. Yeah. Risk. I will cover. I have subsequent slides in the risk. It's the very critical component of a project management. So we'll discuss about the risk in detail. But this is again, it comes in the planning. Communication. We heard, like, if we say something to this is a communication. No, we have to prepare a proper communication plan. When, what, and what contents that we have to communicate to our stakeholders, to our project team, or to the sponsors of my projects, or to whoever is working with me in that particular thing. So when and what are the contexts that I have to communicate? So this is a very critical thing, because this is communication only, we come to know that where is the gap into that project. Procurement, we have to procure the things, like if I'm working on to the network projects, I have to procure the routers, switches, I have to work on to the cabling perspective, I have to procure the racks. So here comes my procurement. Stakeholders. Stakeholders are the people who influence the project from major and a minor perspective. And these are the people, impact the project as well. They are always there with the project, and we have to do a stakeholder management. They can be either your customer, or either from your own organization, or from your own team as well. These are the person who closely watch your project. Okay, going to the next slide. Like I said, we will go in detail into the particular modules. So the risk management is the one of them. Risk is something that we have not expected, or we just foresee that this may happen. This may happen, and this may impact my project positively or negatively as well. So that is basically risk. So how we counter that, we can avoid, we mitigate, we transfer, and accept the risk. So this is basically the different kind of risk management. To avoid the risk is basically say how we will avoid the risk. I'll give you the example, like if you're building in a house at the bank of a river, you know that there are chances of coming of the flood, and it can be an earthquake prone area. So how you can avoid that risk? You can shift your house to the place where the chances of the flood is very less, where the earthquake area is not prone to the earthquake area. So that is the avoidance. You are avoiding the risk, eliminating the risk completely. Mitigate. Mitigate is basically you reduce the probability and the impact of that particular risk. There are somebody from the computer engineering side, they know that they're doing the testing when they're roll out any program or anything. So it's not like that the bug will not come or some leakage will not happen, something will happen. But if you do a recurring testing, you do the several testing, you reduces the impact or the probability of something get unsuccessful. Transfer is basically shifting to the third party. So we purchase an insurance for our cars or for our vehicles. So what we're doing is we are transferring the financial this risk to a third party, to an insurance company. Acceptance is something that we accept that this we cannot change. Like in any day, I read in a newspaper that the prices of a steel has increased and I'm building a house. So we cannot do anything. I have to acknowledge that the cost of building my house, it will increase. So I have to accept that risk. So these are the risks basically that we have to manage while we're working on a project. There are some other components as well, which while we do the project management, how we do the create the project charter, what are the inputs, how we will create a risk register, because to track a risk, we create a risk register. This will have all the risk, how we mitigate, what are the probability, it's a low, high, medium, and what are the mitigations. So those are the things that we will cover into the risk management. Like I said, we segregate and identify the risk as a very low, low, moderate, high, very high, and accordingly we calculate the risk for that particular activity. Project triangle, this is what we have discussed: time, cost, and quality. What is the time management? Time management is basically the sequencing of, we have seen into the project plan earlier that we have the activity. So we have to sequence that activity with the duration, with the time, how much that particular activity is taking the time. So this is what it comes into the time management. It's very good and very critical. In fact, if we are going for our exams and if we do a proper and thorough time management, we're able to complete everything on time. We know that this is the subject I will do into this particular time, this subject I will do this particular time. So I cover each and everything if I do a proper time management. And these are the further on the time ledger, how I estimate the activity duration, how I elaborate the particular schedule activities. This is everything we can do into the MS project. Like MS Project Lab, we have seen it as a sample in the previous slide. The relationship between the activities A and B, what we have in the in MS project, there are several activities. So we have to connect one activity with another activity. One activity is finishing and other activity is starting. So we have to connect it accordingly. And some activities are connected to each other as a finish to finish. Some are start to start, some are start to finish. This we can capture in a more detail when, like, I believe we have to go for the workshop for that. That is MS project, where we have complete this thing, like how one activity starts, one activity finishes, another activity starts, and one finishes related to the other finish of other activity. So this is what is there in the time management. Then we have the logical diagrams, the network diagrams is again onto the start to the finish, how we get connected from like all the dots or the blocks in the that particular activity from start to finish. We go in a parallel, sometimes we go as a dependency from one block to the another block in a sequencing as well. So this is how is the network logic. And when something is getting delayed or early start, we call it a float or the free float. So these are some examples of the float, free float, and the red line you can see is a critical path. If we have to fast track some project, so you can see the start, if we go by like the blue lines, it finishes here, not in time. So then we have to go to the critical path, so the red line, we go from D to E and finishes here. So this is, we can well explain in the project plan, in the MS project plans, like how we are finding the critical paths. Then we have an example, the project life cycle, how it works in a pharmaceutical companies, like how the drugs are sourcing, then the screening, then it go into the formulation stability, then onto the post integrations activities. So this is basically a kind of the project life cycle if we have to work for some pharmaceutical company. And scope we have earlier also have seen, it plays in a very important role. It basically capture what are the things that I have in that particular, what are my boundaries, what are my plans, how I verify my scope, how I can change the control. So this scope management is basically capture the scope definition, the major deliverables. The major deliverable means the major milestone that I have to deliver. Then it's a planning, scope planning, then it's a scope statement. So this is what it covers in the scope management. This is something, a structure, how it works from program to the series of, like it's an aviation and example where the major component assembles, sub-assemble and elementary components. So this is a classic example of a structure, like how it works and how it produces. And the most important here is the bill of material, the fast diagrams, and the structure tool that describes the product. Bill of material is basically in totality, what are the things that will that completely encapsulates a whole product. Go to the next one. This is a kind of example from a software product release. This is a work breakdown structure. Work breakdown structure, we have divided each and everything into the small blocks. And we track that blocks against each product, like project management, planning, meetings, administration, if it's doing or not. So this we create the one vertical project management and the product requirement, detailed design, construct, integration, and test. So this is how a software product, when we are releasing, you have heard of like the Microsoft project and all. Basically, they have the several release. So this is how it works. Cost management. Cost is always an important, it plays an important role and how it does. resource planning, cost estimation, budgeting, and control. This graph shows how at the end and the finishing, we have to meet up the line what we have budgeted for. So initially, it is a very low in the intermediate phase. It's exponentially, it increases. Then it finally it touches the last budgeted cost. This is some of the jargons there into their project management. What is the planned value, earned value, and actual cost? So when we are doing any project, we always do like, this is the cost I will budget it for this, that we call it a plan. And whatever we have earned in that particular cost, we call it earned value and actual cost. So we do a cost benefit analysis that this is what I have anticipated in this project. And this is the cost saving or the cost benefit I have into this particular project. So those are the things that we will carry into this PV, EV, and actual cost. Quality is basically is a plan, do, check, and act. It's, we call it a deeming cycle. What we have to do in all aspects, it's not necessary that while you're working in a job, while we are studying as well, we have to plan our things, then we have to do, check the things, then act. So if you follow this particular cycle, you will find a 0.001% error in your project planning or in any delivery. So this is a well proven and well the cycle where it has the most of the success. This is project quality management. Then quality management, we have the quality planning, quality assurance, quality control, and the last I have to just capture onto the human resources. We have discussed onto the time, cost, and scope as well. But human resources, without human resources, nothing can happen. So this human resources is basically who decide, who is responsible, who controls, who takes the benefit of. Like we'll take an example of a car company. So if we have like all these parameters, like who decides what or who is responsible for that, what particular thing, and who controls and who takes the benefit of. So these are the things that is human resource management will play an important role. And it's further subcontracting also, because sometimes you have not have all the resources available to complete that. So there, then you subcontract further to your another vendor, another company, but it's not your partner, it's a vendor. Let's say you are doing some project or some particular thing, but you have not have required resources. So what you do is you call up some other organization like the Microsoft or some other Amazon or somebody, this is what I'm doing, if you can please help me into the, you have the expertise onto the Microsoft thing, why don't you help us on here? So this is called subcontracting. In the last slide I have what's next. This basically comes to all of your mind, especially the students in our final year. What's next? Shall I do GATE, UPSC? I do GRE, IELTS, or CAT? So what I will say, whatever you will do or whichever field you will go, project management plays a very important role, because this is like a kind of thing which gives you an extra edge over your peers, your colleagues, your friends. So because you are able to manage your day-to-day jobs, your work more efficiently. So this is basically the next, and if you want to see some like material for the project management, you can take this reference as a PMIA.org, it's an official site, and you can have the reading material from the project management site. Thanks, that's it from my side for the project management. Any questions or it's most welcome.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing such a deep knowledge with us. So right now we have so many queries in our question box. So the first question is on Facebook chat section. So this is asked by Abhishek Gupta. Thank you for your valuable information. Please support to teach us what is the difference between program management versus project management.
Yeah, good question. In fact, I was just thinking to capture this into the, my slides as well. See, project is one project where we have like, we are only working on one particular thing. So let's say I will give an example of a data center. In a data center, there are several components, several things are there. So in a project management, I'm only working on a one particular track. I'm working only onto the Wintel or Unix or Linux. I'm working on that particular project. But in a program management, it comes the number of projects in that particular scene. Like let's say the complete data center. I'm migrating a complete data center from location A to location B. This becomes a complete program. So program is basically the multiple projects on that particular stream only, like the Wintel, Unix, Linux, and some other projects related to the networking in that data center becomes a one program. So that's a program management.
Thank you, sir. So yeah. As you know, we have some students watching us live on Facebook as well as on Zoom itself. So the next question is by Avya Jain, student BMIET with us on Zoom.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir, my name is Avya Jain from BMIT College, for, second year CSE student. So, sir, my basic question was, sir, what is the basic key attributes of project management?
Basic attributes, like we have discussed in the previous slide, I believe you have not joined with the initial discussion. So, in the project management, we should know about the scope, we should know about the time, we should know about the risk, we should know about the, there are 10 processes are there. If you want, I will show you the slide. Okay, it's not able to share it. That's fine. There are 10 process areas that we have and the 5 knowledge areas. So that 10 process areas are scope, time, cost, then we have a risk, then we have a communication, then we have basically the cost. So these are the basically all the attributes and the components of our project. I hope I have answered your question.
Thank you, sir. So the next question is from Manish, student, BMIET.
Hello, sir. Sir, my name is Manish and I would like to ask that what are the things we should do as a student to be good in the communication skills? As we know that we are going to be in the IT industry and should do some of the things which will require our skills to be improved in that particular area. And what are the things which matters communication skill in project management?
Very good question. Very good question, Manish. I appreciate you have asked this question. In fact, this will be a success factor when you are going to the corporate world. A good communication skills is of every time it excels you from your colleagues, from your partners, from your peers. So communication skill is not only speaking a good English or you're fluent in English. Communication skills, basically how you write, how you're able to communicate your message to the other person. So here your writing skills comes into the picture. Here your body language when you're talking to somebody, how you talk, your eye contact is how is your eye contact, how is your body language. So to improve that, I believe you have to practice that in your college with your friends. I believe you have a very good faculty with Mr. Jan, Mr. Juneja is there. So they are organizing those kind of things. So there you have to practice, you have to come on stage, you have to take any topic and you have to speak out. English, mind this, English is not a good communication skill. If you're very good in English, very good fluent in English, that doesn't mean that you have a good communication. Communication skills is something, your body language, something your eye contact, something, the message you are passing on to others. I hope I answered your question, Manish.
Thank you, sir. So now the other question is from Stuti, student BMIET.
Good evening, sir. My name is Stuti, and yeah, I have two queries.
Yeah, please.
So my first query is that whether project management is required for a fresher, or is it required when we are experienced and go for managerial position?
Oh, good. In fact, like I said, project management is something, it looks like a very professional or very big word, but this is something in our daily life also we practice, we have to practice. And if you see, like I said, an event is something that I'm managing, it's a small event at my home as well. So that is again a project. It has a start time, it has an end time as well. So if I categorize it that way, I am able to deliver the things. So I believe we have to start practicing this is our, from our student life itself. We should not wait that I will go to the managerial skills or I will go to the something MBA or something, then only I will practice the project manager. No, this is important for each and everybody. This is your business. Yes, this is everybody's business. This is something like, we have to start practicing from our college days itself. So we should not wait. Like I said, an engineer, that doesn't mean he is only working on the technical things. I'm a software engineer, so I will work only into the writing into the Java programs or Python programs or some other programming. No, I should know that how I will present that, how I will market that, how I deliver that. So I should start practicing that in my from my college days itself. Yeah. I hope I answer your question.
And my second query was, yes, sir, definitely. And so my second query was that what is the difference between role of a business analyst and a project manager?
See, business analyst is completely focused on one particular vertical itself. Let's say a business analyst in a banking industry, he only focuses on that particular vertical on how he will get the business for that particular from the financial perspective, from the how he will have the more people taking the loan or mortgages or from other things from that. He's focused only on a one vertical of that particular industry which he's working on. Project manager is an evergreen person who works horizontally across any business, whether it's a pharmaceutical, whether it's a banking industry, whether it's an IT industry, everywhere. Like I said, it's a part of our daily life. So project manager is the person who fits in everywhere. In cricket terms, I will say he's an all-rounder. And the business analyst is the person who only is a specialization in the one particular thing, analysis of that particular business. That's it.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir. So the next question is by Monish, student BMIET.
Yeah, Monish.
Good evening, sir. My name is Monish Jain. I have a question about planning. Planning is always a critical phase for any activity we do. What parameter ensure that planning for a project is well thought and executable?
Yeah, in fact, in the last half an hour or 45 minutes, we have discussed the same thing in a planning perspective. Like planning, we should have a better scope. We have the time management. We sequence the activities. We know who are, so in most importance is my project team. Who is the people in my project team? Let's say I'm working on some software projects. So, and I hired the person in my project team who is expert on the networking side. He's the guy who's a CCNA, CCI, or some Cisco expert, and I'm delivering a software project. So will it work? No, because I have not have done the right planning of the right resources for my project. So I have to have the right resources in my project team so that we are able to deliver the right thing. Secondly, I should understand the scope. Like the slide I've shown it to you, the person asked for the red color two-wheel, basically a car type of thing. So what he delivers a kind of character. So this is why it has done, because we have not understood the scope. If we have would have understood the scope, we are able to deliver the same thing. So we should understand the scope clearly and understand and get it verified with the person who is delivering it, who has given assign us the project. Third thing is the time, at what time we have to deliver, and when is the start date, when is the end date, what are the basically the different phases, initiation, then the planning, then implementation, then monitoring, control, and the closure. So between that five phases, we are able to deliver those things. And then finally, the quality thing, that is basically the triangle of the three things, that we are able to deliver the quality or not. So this is what it comes in the planning. We have to very cautiously, we have to plan the things. If your planning is correct, we are able to achieve 100%. So this planning is kind of an access or a success factor of any project. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
So now I would like to request our Associate Director, Dr. Raghunath Janeja. So would you like to share some views on today's session?
Good evening, everyone. And thank you so much, Mr. Tarun Jain, to be kind enough to be here with us and share your thoughts on project management. I think that this that project management is not only something that is to be when you are a manager or something related to management. It is an art of living, actually. So it can be incorporated in our day-to-day lives also, and if we start, it can be rightly planned and well executed, and the results and objectives be appropriately. So the students from final year who are currently watching it, it's currently one of the most important area where you are working right now, as you are taking on your minor projects and started planning on them, and you have some things you can take on from this seminar and start implementing those things in the kind of projects that you choose and the kind of execution that you make. So I think that this session that you have attended, it would be good insight for you to incorporate this project management, the concept project management and managing things into it. And I hope everybody must have gained a lot from this. And thank you once again, Tarunji, for sparing time with us. And we hope that after the period, we will be fortunate enough to have you in our campus. Though you have been visiting our campus often, but we have not been able to harness the talent from you in a one-to-one face-on. So I hope that next time, whenever you visit us after this COVID era, we'll be fortunate to have you as a presenter, as a keynote speaker in one of our events. And thank you so much once again. Thanks,
Abhinavji. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks. Now, I would like to request our Dean, Academics, Dr. Vishal Jain. Sir, would you like to say something?
Yeah, thank you, Janaya. At the outset, sir, thank you so much for sparing time. On just a mere request, you agreed to present. I know you are very busy and you work on a different time schedule. You work for the projects in Europe. So I think this is the sleeping time for you. And the day you work, and I think this topic is a very broad one, as Abhinavji and you already covered the major aspects of the project management, not only in the job, but when a person is studying for exams, anything day-to-day life, project management is required. And I'm sure all the students would be benefited from today's webinar. And as you have also promised that once this COVID-19 situation is better under control, we'll definitely keep more sessions one-to-one, because you told earlier also that a broad topic cannot be covered in just a webinar, exactly. One shot. So we can have a classroom study as well, provided you are free and taking into consideration your free time. And I think this is wonderful. As Abhinav also told you, came so many times to the campus, but it's the first time that we got a hold on you. And you are here with us. and it was really nice to see you one to one. Thank you so much.
I would like to add one more thing.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Sir, I would like to add one more. Your slides, you mentioned that you gave some statistical data about the failure of projects and the projects, those which start and those end up, those who end up successfully. There's a lot of gap between the started projects and the successfully ending projects. So I just was taking a class of my students after that and was just explaining them that whatever project you start with good speed, but it is not always, the statistical data always shows that projects never end up as a completed project, but you should have spirits to start them at least. So people, sometimes students taking final year projects, taking different projects, taking any kind of assignment, they are really afraid of starting. So what is your view about taking and starting on the projects?
I think they should not afraid of doing the same thing. And the secondly, there's a one Microsoft project that I have shared with you earlier. So if they start working onto the final year students when they will go into the corporate world, so this is very often they have to work on the Microsoft projects and all. So if they start working on that, and it will give them some confidence, like how they were tracking the things, how they are budgeting the things, and how if something is going behind schedule or it's going ahead, so they're able to track it. They're able to see those things. So it's a very good tool. And in fact, this is the part of the Microsoft Office only. The all can download it from the Microsoft site as well. And it gives them a good confidence while working on the projects. Because it gives you the complete synopsis of a complete project.
So I hope the students will be able to take the benefit from this Microsoft tool also that Tarunji has referred, and start streamlining their work that they take on.
Sure.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for having me here. Thank you.
Sir, there is one question. Sorry to interrupt in between. On Facebook, Mr. Vishal Kumari has just asked one question. It appears that he is a final year student. He says that as a HCL project manager, what is the requirement as a final year student to get job offered by HCL company for CSE and other branches?
Definitely, I will ask HCL management to come into the your college as well for the college interviews and as well. But I believe the HCL, they have it every semester you have in a first division. That is the mandatory. Secondly, the person should have the good communication skills, like the ingredients that we have said, like good communication skills, vocal, and have the basically the good knowledge of the particular subject. So those are the things, and it's not a rocket science to be either in HCL or Google or any other organization. Basically, you have to look for a profile. You should not look for an organization. You will get N number of organizations, but the profile is very good. If you get some X company as well with a good profile, I will say, go and grab it. So that is the more important.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks a lot. So now, this is the time to mark the end of such a knowledgeable session today. Thank you all for being such a great and supportive audience to us. And a special thanks to our today's speaker, Mr. Tarun Jain. So see you all in the next session coming more. Thank you all for joining us today.
Thank you, Jania. You've been a wonderful host. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.